couch.
Oh, I don't know why. I don't know why or how. There's a dead merchant. There's a dead merchant in my house. I don't remember what was going on here. Did I move him into here and then kill him just so I can take his stuff and not get a bounty? Is that what I did? So if I did that, I don't remember doing it. And it looks like my house hasn't reset itself, so the body's still here. I haven't been in this house for like a month. So I'll have to check how often the house interior gets reset. I thought it was like once a week. Going through my old chest of junk here, collecting Daedric weapons, I was thinking of Rigmore and how she gave me this razor that I have in the chest. It's like she just gave it to me. It was one of her quest items. She's like, yes. Oh, here, have a sword.
Of course.
Have a sword, have a knife, you know, free. Don't have to do anything except install Rigmore. And I'm like, I've seen this razor before. I think it belongs with a quest. I think this is a cheat. Rigmore is a freaking money cheat. And she is. She's about a 2 or 3% money cheat compared to other mods. But, yeah, going through my chest there reminded me of her. And I thought, you know, there's got to be a way to get her back in my game. I ripped her out. I ripped out her whole mod, her whole entourage of stuff, everything, all of it. Cleaned her clock, basically. You know, she was gone from my life, my Skyrim life. But I miss her little bald head. And that, homemade armored suit she wore. It looked like a stovetop pipe. That's what she wore for her armor. What was that movie, Back to the Future? Marty throws his armor over his shoulder.
Good to see you, friend.
He sighed in a Clint Eastwood movie one time. Anyway, that's what she wears.
Anytime.
Have you heard the stories about the headless huntsman who's roaming Skyrim at nights?
Meanwhile, we've got God Howard. He's a shrine now.
Nah, I don't think so.
They say that he chops off people's heads? Scary.
It just works.
Oh, I don't believe those rumors, my friend.
It's a sloppy job. The mesh is it replaces the Talos mesh. But it's not a very good replacement because the Talos mesh includes a stand. And the new mesh doesn't have a stand. So sometimes it just, the mesh looks awkward the way it's been placed on the ground sometimes. And the stuff near it, sometimes it's floating in space. But it was a joke. It's a joke mod someone posted on the internet. And of course it gets endorsements because, haha, funny. But there's so many things wrong with that mod. Maybe it's of, you know, a warning of an omen of things to come with the Elder Scrolls 6.
Oh, sorry.
Who knows? I was looking for my house, Carl. I had to resort to using my Aura Whisper to find her. It's like,
oh.
Normally she's just upstairs in the kitchen eating. That's all she ever does is eat. The Riften house is so tiny. You have to go outside to change your mind. Okay, let's count red dots. The dot. And of course, I can't go up the stairs in the dark.
What can I do for you? Good luck out there.
So, she was sitting in the kitchen eating. Plain as day. So I don't know what my problem was.
Divines bless you. Oh, thank you. Divines bless your kind heart.
Yeah?
So the god statue, G-O-D-D, it replaces all the statues, all the Talos statues in Skyrim, except for the one in Windhelm inside the Talos Temple. That one still is Talos. It's not a statue of God Howard. Anyway, so I went on the interweb, found a mod called Just Rigmore. It's Just Rigmore, and I just installed it. There's a few versions of her. I downloaded the one with the bald head, because that's how I remember her mostly, is with the bald head. I want to say it's a play on Dragon Slayer.
Have you visited Rorikstead lately? No matter how harsh the winter, the crops that grow there never falter.
Any of those movies where you got a girl trying to disguise herself as a boy, so she always cuts her hair off, wears boy's clothes. That's pretty much what Rigmore does when you first meet her. So I wasn't exactly sure where she is. I saw her location on a map, but I didn't know what that location was. There's a patch that comes with Just Rigmore so that you turn off the borders. Turn off the invisible borders, because you have to be able to get close to the borders to even talk to her. Because Rigmore is sort of off limits if you don't have the patch installed. You'll see her, but you won't be able to walk up to her, because it will say, "You can't continue in this direction anymore," sort of thing. So I forget who all was with us. Was it Luna and Vilya? I'm trying not to go too fast because I don't want Luna to go flying off the back seat. feels like I'm going the wrong way. So she's way over. Where is she? Where? She's over there somewhere.
What was that?
Oh, she went flying off. Sometimes she flies off when I arm myself. If I bump into her, or if she bumps into me like she just did, she'll run into the horse's butt, and that triggers her to sit up on the saddle with me. She has to touch the horse. If she doesn't touch the horse, then she just stands and runs behind me. One of these bandits here became immortal. I can't kill them anymore. So maybe it'll show up in this battle of what happened.
You must admit that I'm not bad.
Come on, get back on the horse. Okay. Well, I didn't see anything that time. It looks like all the bandits died. But now, whenever I come by here, there's this one bandit. Weapons and spells go right through him. He's not even affected by it. So I'm not sure what to do with that character. If he's going to keep spawning that way, or if it's just a one-time deal or what. I looked at his record in the ESP or the ESM file, and he looks normal. I don't see any weird setting just for him. But while I was in the editor, I was fixing other things. I was fixing the venison chop. Venison chop is, the weight is 2. But when you make venison chop out of venison, you end up with 5 venison chops, and each one is 2 weight. So you end up with 10 weight instead of 2 weight in your inventory. I don't know what's causing that. So I went in there and I made venison 10 weight. So when it gets chopped up, then it's 2 weight each. Oh, this isn't good. This is why you're not allowed to go off the edge of the map. This kind of stuff happens. Anyway, my frame rate was approaching 1. 1 FPS. As I was trying to look ahead. What's up ahead? Is there anything? Is nothing? No thing. There's no Cyrodiil waiting for me down there. So when I came back in, that's when my FPS started going through the roof. I was like, okay, where's Rigmor? Who's hogging up all my CPU time here? There's the horse. That's her horse. Oh, the lag. The lag's killing me. Anyway, Rigmor was sitting in a chair right in front of me, and I didn't even see her, because she's like in camouflage with all these trees here. And I thought, well, maybe my grass mod's interfering with her little campsite she's got set up there. She has a tent. She has a little fireplace. What else she got? She's got herself sitting in a chair. But yeah, the frame rate was just killing my game. So, went back to a previous save, rode the bikes up here casual, all casual-like, and I didn't have an issue with frame rates that I could tell. Anyway, so there's Rigmor with her bald head. She doesn't talk. I mean, she says a few things.
You just do what you gotta do, and I'll follow, okay?
She doesn't do any commentary. Alright, take that back. She'll say something once. When you visit a town, she'll say something the first time you visit the town. That's it. Anyway, so she does come with some stuff, it looks like.
What is it?
And you get this note from her. And whenever you read the note, it spawns her to your location. Now I have to remember how she works. She has to be staying near her horse to get to her horse. So, there's nothing going on here. I thought we have to go through this. Oh, there's Red Mountain. Maybe that's what was blowing up my frame rate, was Red Mountain was trying to fit where normally the White Gold Tower sits. Anyway, now that that's fixed, I can get away from the world's edge there and see about getting my follower to sit on the horse. I realized she doesn't have a horse. And the minute she sits down on the horse, my game crashed. I was like, why? Why? Let's try again. Everyone on your horses. I rode somewhere where I thought was more of a safe space, and then try again, and she worked perfectly the next time. There's a lot of glitches coming off the horses. Oftentimes an NPC will jump off their horse, and then they're underground. They didn't revert back to a human body. They still remained a horse sitter. So their ass is on the ground. Their center of gravity is way off. It's all thrown off kilter. And I still have problems with Vilya. It's about 50-50 chance when she jumps off her horse, her spine's broken. So I can either fast travel somewhere to fix her, or I just have her get back on the horse and then get off the horse, and that usually fixes her back. And what else? Killing two birds with one stone here. I'm supposed to go to Fort Dawnguard anyway and get some stuff done.